In this video, we will discuss the clinical uses of indirect acting parasympathomimetics. Parasympathomimetics are classified as direct acting agonists and indirect acting agonists. Direct acting agonists are further divided into choline esters and alkaloids, while indirect acting agonists or acetylcholinesterases are classified as reversible agents and irreversible agents. And this is the classification from the last video. In the previous video, we discussed the classification briefly and clinical uses of direct acting parasympathomimetics, while this video will be all about the clinical uses of indirect acting parasympathomimetics. Indirect acting agonists show their actions by binding to enzymes in the synaptic cleft. The released acetylcholine is metabolized by acetylcholinesterase enzyme and remove it from the synaptic cleft. By inhibiting this enzyme, indirect acting agents inhibit the metabolism or hydrolysis of acetylcholine in the synaptic cleft. That's how these agents increase the level of acetylcholine by inhibiting its degradation. As discussed, these agents are further classified as reversible agents and irreversible agents. Reversible agents reversibly inhibit the acetylcholinesterase enzyme and are widely used clinically. In these, the first one is Edrophonium. Edrophonium is a short-acting acetylcholinesterase enzyme reversible inhibitor. Its actions is only limited to the periphery and cannot cross the blood-brain barrier and is readily eliminated renally. Clinically, it is used for the diagnosis and acute treatment of myasthenia gravis, which is an autoimmune disease caused by the development of antibodies against the nicotinic receptors of neuromuscular junctions. This causes weakening of skeletal muscles. Besides this, Edrophonium is used as an antagonist of non-depolarizing neuromuscular blockers. Next, we have the drug Physostigmine. Physostigmine is a natural alkaloid of calabarbine, which can cross the blood-brain barrier. This is therapeutically used for chronic glaucoma and in the treatment of overdoses of drugs with anticholinergic actions such as atropine and tricyclic antidepressants. After this, we have the drug Neostigmine. Like Physostigmine, it is also a reversible inhibitor of acetylcholinesterase. Neostigmine is a synthetic compound and cannot cross the blood-brain barrier to reach the brain. Therapeutically, it is used for myasthenia gravis, is an antagonist for non-depolarizing neuromuscular blockers, and for stimulating the GI tract and urinary bladder, and for postoperative ileus and urinary retention. Pyridostigmine and Ambenonium are the other reversible inhibitors of acetylcholinesterase and resemble Neostigmine, but these both have a long duration of action than Neostigmine. Therapeutically, these are used for the chronic management of myasthenia gravis. Rivastigmine, Galantamine, Tacrine, and donepezil are cholinesterase inhibitors that can cross the blood-brain barrier, which is why they are used for delaying Alzheimer's disease, which is a neurodegenerative disease of cholinergic neurons of the central nervous system. Thus, these drugs help by extending the duration of acetylcholine's action in CNS. In these drugs, Tacrine is not used anymore because of its hepatotoxic property. These agents are considered relatively selective inhibitors of CNS cholinesterases. The remaining agents are irreversible acetylcholinesterase inhibitors and include organophosphate compounds. it contains drugs like echothiopate. Echothiopate irreversibly binds to the acetylcholinesterase enzyme, and the restoration of the activity of this enzyme requires the synthesis of new enzymes. Echothiopate is rarely used for treating chronic glaucoma. It has a long duration of action, about 100 hours. After this, other agents like parathion and malathion are not used clinically, but as an insecticide and have toxicological importance. At the same time, Soman and Sarin are nerve gases used in warfare. In the case of organophosphate poisoning, pralidoxime is used as an antidote. Pralidoxime is used to reactivate the inhibited acetylcholinesterase, but only reverses the peripheral effect and is ineffective in case of CNS poisoning, because it cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. However, if it is not given before the aging of the complex to occur, then the enzyme cannot be reactivated. Aging occurs when the complex loses an alkyl group. To treat the CNS effects, atropine and benzodiazepines may be used, and other supportive measures may also be necessary. Furthermore, pralidoxime is ineffective in reversible agonist toxicity, for example, physostigmine and neostigmines, etc. If you want us to make a video on organophosphate poisoning and its clinical management, then please tell us in the comment section. And with this, thanks for watching. Do like and share this video with your friends, and support us by subscribing to our channel.